There's a foundation, a pivot point. Yeah? A platform. So we need to realize what is the ruh, the spirit of Ramadan. Because alhamdulillah, if we realize what that is, then with the fadl and karam of Allah, we still have time. There's a lot of time left. Great days and nights are to come. It's in front of us, this final third, the last ashra. Then we'll succeed. If we realize. So what do we need to now realize and learn? What is the ruh of Ramadan? If we take the ruh out of Ramadan, then the Ramadan, the month will pass just like the previous and the months to come after. But as I said, everything has its strength and physical strength. So if we bring the ruh into our Ramadan, then our whole month of Ramadan, it will sparkle. It will become good. So the ruh is what? What is the ruh? And it is such an ibadah that Allah Ta'ala has kept in Ramadan. If we fulfill this ibadah, then we will achieve Ramadan, the objective of Ramadan, if we realize what is the spirit of Ramadan and we implement that spirit of Ramadan. So the ruh, the spirit, the foundation of Ramadan is dua. It is dua, prayer, supplication to Allah, asking from Allah. Request. I'm telling you the ruh of Ramadan, from the first of Ramadan until the last day of Ramadan. And all these Laylatul Qadr nights, what do we say? Do dua, pray. If you take dua out, if you take the prayer supplication out, then nothing will be left. So dua, supplicating to Allah, requesting Allah. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that dua is very important for us. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the importance is placed on dua. On prayer, pleading to Allah, supplicating to Allah, requesting to Allah. So in reality, this month of Ramadan that Allah Ta'ala has given to us, it has a strong relationship. And to make the connection between the human being and Allah, Allah says that only that person would do dua to Allah who considers Allah as Allah. Who considers that Allah is the one to give. Allah is my data. He is the one who will give. Even if I'm a sinner, I am a waster, I am bone idol, whatever I am, but Allah will give to me. It's just like the connection between the mother and the child. Just like the child, he maybe will disobey the mother, but he runs back. The more the mother, maybe even... Yes, whichever human being, believer, Allah gives the ability, the tawfiq to do dua, then in the hadith it is stated, for that person the doors of rahmah have opened up. The doors of Jannah have opened up. And the doors of acceptance have opened up. Subhanallah. So this is dua. The three elements of dua. Three things open up. When a person does dua to Allah, raises his hands, supplicates to Allah, then immediately, and let's focus on this. The three special times in Ramadan where Allah Ta'ala listens to the duas. And we cannot get these moments in the rest of the year. This time will not, these moments will not come in the rest of the year. It's only Ramadan that can give us these three moments that we can make the dua to Allah. So be careful about this. What are those three moments? Morning time, when we keep the fast, when we observe the suhoor, sahri time, when we are partaking in the pre-dawn meal, that is the very high percentage of acceptance at that time of dua. That when a person gets up in the morning and has the pre-dawn meal at the time of sahri suhoor, then definitely make dua to Allah at that time. Because it's a very special time of dua. Whatever difficulties, problems, issues you have, at that time ask from Allah when you are partaking in the pre-dawn meal. But because we are in a rush at that time, let me eat quickly and have a meal. But what a big time we waste at that time. So what should we do? What should we do is that we should prepare in advance. We should prepare in advance. We should have such a preparation that after eating, if you get even 5 minutes spare time after eating before dawn, sun, the Subah Sadiq time comes, then ask from Allah at that time whatever you need to ask from Allah. Because that time will not come back. That time, those moments will not come in the rest of the year. So if we collect all of our needs at that time, when it's Sahri time, pre-dawn meal, after eating, keep aside 5, 6, 10 minutes spare after eating. Don't look, oh, it's only 2 minutes left, I've got to eat, let me drink water, let me drink tea. No. Have the meal in a bit of advance. That is such a great opportunity and a time to ask from Allah at that time. And we waste that time. We waste that time. And the second time in Ramadan, which we don't get during the rest of the year, is when we're about to break the fast. When we're about to break the fast. And shaitan, he attacks at that time. When we're about to break the fast, at that time people are talking, having discussions. And insan's focus is, what shall I eat now? Let me eat quickly. Let me prepare the meal. Let's put the food mat out. So we worry about our hunger. And that is the time that the person's at that time feeling, it doesn't feel like he wants to ask from Allah. And at that time, we are in desperate need. We should ask from Allah at the time. It's such a valuable time, the iftar time, breaking the fast. And we waste that time as well. We waste that time as well. So that's the second time in Ramadan when du'as are most easily, readily accepted. So we should prepare at that time to make du'as to Allah. We should ask from Allah at that time. And the third time that Allah has given to us, which we won't get the rest of the year. What is that time in Ramadan? At the time of Taraweeh. Yes, so Taraweeh Salah, an extra prayer that Allah has given to us in Ramadan. The whole of the Quran is recited at that time. It's Quran upon Quran upon Quran. And lengthy recitation with ease and enjoyment. And a person's reciting Quran and others are listening and everyone's immersed. People are stood and he's listening to the words of Allah. He's going into sujood and prostration. And this time is very essential that we will not get the rest of the year. And during the year, maybe we'll not get Ramadan next year. And Allah Ta'ala has given a lot of time at that time. We should see that 30, 45 minutes, an hour it takes. During that time, alhamdulillah, we should ask from Allah at that time. You know, you get the spare time in between the two rakats, or you get 2 minutes break at various intervals. Straight away make dua to Allah at that time. The intervals in between, the rakats, the rest break periods. So at that time, ask from Allah, subhanAllah. But Allah, please cast your mercy upon me, your blessings on me. Please be merciful to me in such a way that give me such a sincere friend. Subhanallah, what an ajeeb dua. That Allah, you understand, mukhlis, that all friends are friends. I am your friend and you are somebody's friend. But this is friendship just until to the extent of shaking hand. But one is a mukhlis friend, a sincere friend who loves the friend, who shares in the sadness of the friend, who shares in the happiness of the friend. From the depths of the heart, he sacrifices for his friend. This is called mukhlis, friend with ikhlas, with sincerity. What's he asking? That Allah, oh my Rabb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have we ever asked this? We probably have never asked this. We should try and ask for this, subhanallah. That, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Rabb, you'll get the whole deen from this dua. Remember this with the fadal of Allah, if you make this dua. If you recite, you will go into Jannah reciting the kalima. If this dua of yours is accepted, inshallah it will be. That Allah, give me such a friend, give me such a sincere friend, mukhlis friend. And what's his speciality, the friend? Allah, of this friend, that when he sees in me a loss, a deficiency, or a sin, or a deficiency, or a defect, then that he warns me when he sees a negative in me. Say, Subhanallah. Subhanallah. What a great dua. Subhanallah. Do you find a friend like this? That give me the prayer in Jamaat. Allahu Akbar. Say, Subhanallah. And this enjoyment, ask that person who prays Salah in Jamaat. And he asks from Allah and he runs to Jamaat. Subhanallah. A person's heartbeat, that need to go. I don't want Jamaat to pass. I don't want everything. I swear by Allah, everything else looks bad for that person. He starts to dislike wife, children, starts to dislike business. A deep sweat comes in the body. The people tell me this. They're not with me because I'm a wealthy person.